Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with some more Let's Play this here Darksiders War Mastered Edition. I checked, and that's what it's called. It's a stupid name, but that's what it's called. On that there PC. Right, we have been stripped of all of our powers, all the powers that one might expect a horseman of the apocalypse to have. And we've been spat back down to Earth, apparently really fucking iffily as well. Yeah, we've been spat back down to Earth, iffily. Apparently the charred council a bad shot, and we must, try and find the demon Vulgrim. Because apparently he can help us in some ill-defined way. You know, it looks like... Oh, did it.
Here comes the welcome party. War, why don't you introduce yourself?
Don't fucking say that like it was your idea, Mark Hamill. Like, I'd already drawn my sword. Like, what the fuck do you think I'm gonna do? Oh, no. You know what? Based purely on the fact that there's zombies everywhere, I don't think humanity came out of that war too well. Well, say war. More completely one-sided slaughter. Actually, no, it was a two-sided slaughter. It was two sides slaughtering each other and... but also utterly destroying the third side, so... It was a triple... yeah, it was a two-sided slaughter. Two-sided slaughter, unfortunately, the shape is a triangle. That's what I was going for. I mean, I didn't fucking make the particular trip. I mean, I did just take a remarkably long trip to get ultimately to, you know, my destination and not a particularly good joke. But, hey, what are you gonna do? That's how life turns out sometimes. Oh, good! Are you a human? Oh, fuck, well. Whatever you are, you're dead now. I'm sorry, mate. You don't need to tell me which way to go. A giant fucking exploding fat guy just gave me that one away. Go on, this goes near interactive objects, such as chests and objects. Okay, so that's basically telling me when to hit the context sensitive button. I understand. Oh no. Very much in a lot of oh fucking okay. Maybe it's just me. But in a lot of ways, I consider Darksiders to be a very, very old school style of game, if you know what I mean. You know, very traditional, like, I'm not sure how to put it. It's very gaming. This is something I've had issue trying to articulate a fucking game. This is a concept I've had trouble articulating to people for years, but there was a very specific... I think because of the games that I largely played in my... quite want to say... I think formative years might actually be correct on that. Yeah, because I mostly, when I actually started getting into gaming as an active hobby rather than just as a thing I sometimes do, the games that I played were like the PlayStation 2 character platformers and character action games, and for some reason in my head I associate those kinds of gameplay very much with very traditional video gamey design, and this game very much has it, and for some reason a big part of that is the context sensitive button. You know what I mean? Like here, the context sensitive button. In any other situation... Actually, no, I haven't said that. It tends to be mostly grabbing or opening things, but still. You know, in any other situation, I would have just grabbed the thing. But in that one circumstance, it did more than just that. Let me hit them with a table. Awesome. I hit them with a table. My sword hits them. They barely feel it. I hit... Oh yeah, I forgot about this. These like weird dreg things are like so easy to kill that you literally, you can just hit press B at them and you smash them and get infinitely more reward than if you, you know, more legitimately attempted to kill them via button combinations and the pressings and the combos and such. Oh, that's a thing. This game, as the game goes on, I believe you do actually unlock more complex moves. Ladies and gentlemen, please fully expect me to win, to get through this game by bashing buttons. That's how I win action games, because I am not an action game man. I am a strategy game man, and I'm not particularly good at that. Smashy! Yeah, because you beat him up, you just get a couple of blue souls, but you do your B attack at them, you get, yeah, one blue soul, but also, you also get health back. You know, it just makes more sense to, you know, crush their little stupid heads like pulp. You know what I mean? That's more in line with what we should be trying here. What we at the Charred Council think is good for humanity is, you know, crushing their heads to pulp. Well, I say humanity. Zombie humanity. Zombanity. Okay, big glowing door, a big glowing barrier. Don't know about you, but that says to me that I've got to keep smashing things until I can't smash them all. Go away, Google, I'm not talking to you. I managed to stop that one before it said anything. I am proud of myself. I am improving. This is why I make the no money on YouTube. Oh good, we're actually getting a demon now. Although weirdly, if I remember correctly, these demons, for some reason, these enemies, I remember distinctly when I played it through the first time, these enemies consistently gave me trouble throughout the entire game. I think it may be because these are enemies that rather heavily rely on dodging, and the dodging in this game is inelegant. It's good to know that he was just completely chock-a-block with souls. You know what I mean? Then again, I suppose, if any creature on a blasted post-apocalyptic Earth is going to be full of souls, it's probably going to be the demons. Because I assume demons eat souls? I don't know if I'm honest. Like, that's more of a guess than anything else. I assume the demons eat souls? Smashy, smashy. Smashy, smashy. Nothing like a good old-fashioned corpse smashing. You know what I mean? I don't need you, but I'm getting you anyway. Why? Because I feel like it, I suppose. Yeah, the more I look at this landscape, the more I'm thinking, I think maybe World of Warcraft took inspiration from this place when the Burning Legion expansion came out.
In Earth years. About a century, long enough for the last of the mouth breathers to die off.
Then, the Third Kingdom is lost.
Okay, good. The cutscene just broke down and... Yep, perfect. Look, I love it. It's great. Again, this is basically what the cutscenes did when I played it through on my own, for some reason. I don't quite understand why, but they did that. Also, it just occurred to me, my brother has actually left the fucking house, so I can now reopen my door and get some more airflow in here.
Subtle. I almost
now,
didn't hear you coming.
Summer, and that is
Voldrum.
The council finally took me seriously. If so... You're surely not empty-handed, or this shall be the briefest of introductions.
Hmm.
There were a few young ones. Oh, spectacular.
It's weird that the cutscene is broken, the power, but
the one called Destroyer.
But strangely, the subtitles and the audio are still synced up.
And the font of his power there. Oh, such haste to die. You aren't even a shadow of your former self. You wouldn't last a heartbeat.
Yeah, I'm gonna
Besides, the way to the tower is shrouded by demon magics. Even I do not know the way.
Who does?
Feed my hunger. And I'll feed your curiosity.
Fuck me, it actually sped up so right at the last second it was back in sync. Yeah, don't know why it's doing that. I'll Google it after this video. See if there's anything I can do to fix that. Could we V-sync? I don't know. Weird things can break in. Okay, so what are we doing? Collect 500 souls for him, man. I believe we do, however, also manage to just kind of accidentally get souls by breaking up the environment, so... No, we don't. Is it, perhaps, killing things with the environment? Yep, killing things with the environment seems to do it. Oh, good, we're actually getting proper enemies coming at us. Alright, come on, you big bastard. Oh, yes, blocking. The thing you can do in this game, which I never do in this game. You know what, unless we get a lot more enemies coming at us, like, soon, it's gonna take a long time to get that enough souls, just saying. Okay, here we go, now we've got some actual enemies. Ow. Sorry, don't mind me. Right, now you can mind me, you big fucking... Big flame-fisted prick! Whoops. Ow. Yeah, as I said, I always had trouble with these big ones. Come on! Just let me beat the crap out of you, it's fine! There we go! Just, you know, if you just let me do that immediately, it would have saved us both a lot of time. There's actually another issue that this game has on occasion, is that you do, on every now and again, run into enemies that are less of a challenge to fight as much as they are a chore because they have a lot of health. Like, that does happen from time to time where you do just kind of, oh, hello. Where you just kind of end up drowning in an enemy's health pool for like half an hour. There we go. That's closer to the money. That's more what I want. I want money because that's what I want. Because it's what I want. Because it's... What I want! It's what I want! Sorry, I'll stop that immediately. No one needs to put up with this. Can I get in here? Ah, there we go. Lovely. Good to know that, you know what? I don't know for why, but for some reason, my brain immediately thought of this area as being a bank. Like, I couldn't tell you why I think this is a bank, but there's just something about this that's a bank.
To feed Volgrim's hunger. Now, maybe he'll feed our curiosity.
Oh, did you really need to basically just... Oh, right, that was just completely gone. Could have just gone there. Right, whatever. But did you really need to just repeat back exactly what Volgrim said to us? Also, whenever I hear Volgrim, it's hard for me to not think of Fulgrim from Warhammer.
These ancient gates have a mind of their own, but with this, you may reach an understanding. Beyond the gate, seek out Samael's prison. Once, Samael was close in power to the Dark Prince himself. Some might even say, a threat. You will find he is no friend to the Destroyer. Seek me out when you've gathered more souls. I will make it worth your while.
So, yep, that's our merchant for the game, and indeed for the next one, and probably for for Darksiders 3 as well. Right. Do I need to actually equip the Earth Call on that? Yes, I do. If I recall correctly, although this thing's primary usage is to open gates like this, though you'll see more about that in a moment, if I recall correctly, you can actually use it to knock enemies back as well. Wakey wakey! There it is. Yeah, by open gate, I mean wake up the gate.
The horn call of my ancestors awakened at last from the dreamless sleep. Then we are free.
None are free while the Destroyer still breathes.
The Destroyer, yes. To his service we are bound, though enemies we remain. So his enemies, we call friend. Pass now, friend. Must bring victory. Must bring freedom.
This is like a really bloody odd thing to do, to seal off an area. To have that sit in the way.
If that was the gate, I can't wait to find out what's behind it.
You know what I mean? Like, just fucking collapse some rubble on it. Oh, awesome, it does physics at the table, I love it. But you know, just collapse some rubble on it. Like, yeah, some fucking rubble's collapsed on this gate, and this gate is gonna remain forever closed. You know what I mean? No need to, like, you know, basically bind a guy who hates you and, from the looks of things, the minute he woke up was going to walk away. To be the gate, like, that's deeply inefficient. Ow. Okay, I'll give you that one. See, it knocks the enemies back. That's a bit of a use. I mean, I'll grant you, it's not great, but better than nothing, isn't it? Rather it did that than precisely fuck off. Yeah, explode, big. Damn it. Oh no, wait, now you're gonna explode. Fuck it. Ah, damn it. I was too close when he exploded. I mean, granted, given the fact that he gives me health, there is kind of an upper limit to how much of a problem he is, but still. I don't think he. Fuck off. I don't think it gives me enough health to cover for the damage he does. Uppity prick. Hello, there's another one. You know what, you little guys, right? Because you basically don't hurt me, but you're enough of an irritant that I want to get rid of you so I can fight your friend. Who, granted, isn't much more of a threat. I mean, he just, again, seems to be a fat dude on fire. I mean, sorry, I'm trying to figure out whether or not this is a demon or whether or not this is supposed to be, like... Oh, you're just laughing. Okay, well, fuck you then. I can't tell if that guy is supposed to be a demon or just one of the humans that's gone a bit weird over the last century. You know what I mean? Like, is he just a fat guy? Like, if I was in this universe, would I turn into him? Like, you know what I mean? These are important fucking questions that I want answered. I don't want to end up looking like that if the apocalypse happens. I think that's a fair thing to worry about. Being absolutely fucking revolting for eternity. Well, I say for eternity. Until, I don't know, this shoulder-padded weirdo shows up to kick fuck out of me. The last thing I want. For good, you things. Which I believe are called hellhounds, but I can't know why I believe that. I don't know. They come from hell and they're kind of animalistic. Hellhound seems like a good name for them. Seems like it would fit. But again, as I say, I don't know why I think they're called that. I just think they are awesome. Sorry, I genuinely couldn't remember whether or not that was a thing you can do. Nah, just kick fuck out of the...
Non straga singura.
Do you know what's imprisoned here? There are things even you should fear, horseman. Once you were strong, but now you are weak and you are alone. The destroyer knows of your coming. Even now, he moves his legions against you.
Then I'll make this quick.
This might be an odd thing to reflect upon, but he threatened me with his moving his legions against me. That's kind of...
Destroy this fool.
There's kind of a limit to how effective an army is, especially multiple armies, like the entire military force of, let's say, a nation, even though I know we're talking about heaven and hell here, but let's say a nation. But it's kind of... There's an upper limit how useful that is against one guy who doesn't stay still. You know what I mean? Because honestly, how do you think he's gonna find me? Like, I'm gonna notice an army coming and I'm gonna go somewhere else. Or I'm just gonna hide and beat up his generals. Or, ow, yep, dodged at the wrong time, I'll give you that one. Or, as seems to be the case right now, I'm gonna just, you know, fight through his armies and beat up his generals. Which, as I said, seems to be what I'm doing now. Granted, I'm not doing it particularly well, but I'm doing it. Oh, awesome, the horn works on him as well. Excellent. And that was just a random mook. I tried that as a boss fight. It was just a mook. Just beat up a mook. Sliced him apart with his own fucking axe, even though he's a mook. That's how angry I was at that one particular fucking mook. Yeah, I can see it. I can see it, Watcher. I can see it, Mark.
Just one hideous blood-puking gargoyle. The plumbing man.
Yeah, this seems like a really... Oh god, the floor's mad at me. But this seems like a really weird way to try to lock away, you know, your arch rival. You know, just... This isn't even a key, really. This relies on there being a shit ton of dudes here at all times. You know what I mean? And there was a guy guarding, like, this prison, which is opened by shifting some statues.
War. Are you here to play executioner? They should have set all four of you.
I have no interest in killing you, Samael.
The destroyer! is beyond your reach, beyond mine.
Has prison made you a coward?
So Ward clearly doesn't give a shit.
Perhaps there is a way, but you will need to get inside the Destroyer's spire. The tower is guarded by four of his chosen. Bring me their hearts and ask me no questions. My reasons for helping you are my own.
Where can I find these guardians?
First, seek the Twilight Cathedral, where the Bat Queen Tiamat has gone to roost. The whole of her domain is a blistered inferno. By land, you will never reach it. Find the high ground with this, and bring me her still beating heart.
No, don't worry, bro, I'm just gonna go back into my prison. Yeah, let's go. Okay, so in order to kill the devil, we talked to the guy who, the runner-up for the devil, who gave us the power of gliding. In the, yeah, the most fucking edgy glide in history. And now we need to go beat up a bat. Cool. Fucking Arthas the Lich King has moved up in the world. Anyway, so that, I think, is a good place to stop that. I'm gonna go fucking look up to see why the cutscenes were acting up earlier, but haven't done just then twice. Whatever. But yeah, that's gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been your unrelated Cyber Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Right, let's cut the crap to this end slate, it doesn't take forever. I want to thank these lovely minions, whose names are on the screen right now, for donating to my Patreon campaign to help keep the channel going. If you want to donate as well and get your name on this list and the one in the description, you can follow the link in the description to my Patreon page and pledge some money there, it would be appreciated. Down there you will also find a link to my Twitter, where I post random bullshit, ranty bullshit, and indeed every single video I put up, because Lord knows, you can't trust YouTube to do it for you anymore. Right, we done? Is it over?
It's over!